In section 2.6, we will discuss the finite square wave. We will consider a finite square wave. So let's say this is our coordinate system, and along this axis we are having the x-axis, and along this axis we are having the potential, which is V of x. And the well is such that it starts from here. The potential is zero unless we reach a point, and from there the potential starts, and the potential goes to its maximum value here, which is minus V naught. And then it is symmetric along both sides. So if this point is minus A on the x-axis, then we will have to move exactly the same distance, and this distance is plus A from the origin. The value of the potential is minus V naught, and then the potential again become zero. So we will consider this potential, and we will solve for the bound state and scattering state of a particle. So the geometry is such that V of x is equal to minus V naught when x is between A and minus A, while this is equal to zero elsewhere. So we will now start with this geometry. This is zero. Elsewhere, Ri can write when x modulus is greater than zero, greater than A, means when on plus x side and on minus x side, I go beyond the A value. So it is this region and this region where the potential is zero, while in this region we are having minus V naught potential applied. And you know that we will have to study in this system the bound states, and in bound states we will automatically take E less than zero, means E negative. And we will study the scattering states, and in scattering states we will take E greater than zero. So these two we will discuss. So the very first one that we are going to discuss are the bound states. Now in bound states, we know that we will have to take E is negative, and we will solve the Schrödinger wave equation. Let's say this is our region 1, this is our region 2, means all this under the potential, and this is our region 3. So we are having three different regions. Zero potential region, but it's on negative side, it's on positive side, while this is region 2, which is under potential. So we will have to solve the Schrödinger wave equation, and let's say I start with region first, and in region first I know that x is less than minus A, means I am further going on this side. V is equal to zero, and now the Schrödinger wave equation is, I know that minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square plus V of x psi equals E psi. Now I will have to solve this equation. When V of x is equal to zero, I will have minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square, is equal to E psi. And now I can move this to the other side. We have solved this many times. So D square psi over dx squared is equal to minus 2me over h bar squared and psi. Now here I will have to suppose the constant here, and let's say I suppose that k is equal to minus 2me in a square root by h bar. Now I'm taking the minus sign here inside the square root because I know that e is negative. When e is negative, then k will be real and positive. So k is real and positive, I can write d square psi over dx square is equal to k square psi. So now I will have to solve this equation, and the solution of this equation I know that it is psi of x, and this is equal. I can write this in exponential form, or I can write this in sine and cosine form. I will prefer, as per my boundary condition, to write the solution in terms of the exponential. So it is a constant ae to the power kx plus be to the power minus kx. Now I will have to apply the boundary condition, and the boundary condition is such that psi should go to zero when x goes to infinity. Now I am on the minus side, so when x will go to minus infinity, then my psi should vanish. If I look at this equation, when x is minus infinity, this one is decaying, this one is going to zero, and if I look to this one, then this one minus x will become plus, and it is growing solution. So my wave function is not accepting this solution, and so the solution is equal to psi of x is equal to a e to the power plus kx, and this is the solution of region 1. And I mark this equation 1, and this is for x less than minus a. Now I can move on to the region 2 as well, but better I do the region 3 because they seem symmetric. So let me do the region 3 first. This is region 3. So now region 3 is also the same. In region 3, I am having x greater than plus a. The v of x is 0 here, and the Schrödinger wave equation will become the same, e minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square is equal to e psi, and I can do the same changes here, mean writing it in this form, then selecting k equal this, and over here in the third region as well, as I'm considering the bound state, so e will be negative and k will be real and positive, and the solution of this equation will become psi of x with another constant, and this is, let's say, f e to the power kx and g e to the power minus kx. So psi of x is equal to f e to the power plus kx and g e to the power minus kx. And now I know that the boundary condition is that sine should go to zero when x goes to plus infinity. And when x goes to plus infinity, then looking to this condition, when x is plus infinity, then this one is growing. And when x is plus infinity, this one is decaying. So this one is going to zero. And my wave function is not accepting this solution. And that's why the solution is that sine of x is equal to g e to the power minus kx. And this is equation 2. And this is for x greater than plus A waves. Now let me come back to region 2, and in region 2 I am having some potential applied, and this is the region where V of x is equal to minus V naught and x is between minus A and plus A. So I am having some potential here. Let me write the Schrödinger wave equation with the potential. So it is minus h bar square 2m d square psi over dx square minus v naught psi equals e psi. So I can write this thing is this v naught will come this side and we will have e plus V naught psi. So the E naught in plus V naught psi will be equal to, means this implies that this is equal to minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square. So I can write that d square psi over d x square is equal to minus 2m over h bar square and e plus v naught psi. And now let me do a supposition, and the supposition is that let me consider that L is equal to 2m e plus V naught square root divided by h bar. Now what's about the value of L? The value of L from here, E is negative while V naught is negative as well. So we will have negative and negative. So two times this, the negative and negative will come here. So our L will become complex then, but we will impose a condition that for if the E value is greater than the minimum potential applied, so we will have the L value is real and positive. When E will be greater than this one, so we will have one negative value here and the net value is negative and E will be itself negative, so it will make L is positive and real. Now we will solve this equation, and the solution of this equation will be that psi of x is, so this condition actually makes L to be real and positive, and I can write that this minus sign means I will put here, and d square psi over dx square is equal to minus L square psi. So this minus L square psi in the general solution of this we have derived many times when this is minus and this will be, let's say, C prime, e to the power plus I k x and d prime e to the power minus I k x. Now the solution in this form, and it can be written in the form of sine and cosine. Both are the same, only the constant will become different. So I'm changing this solution to the sine and cosine for reason which will come later, but this is actually done for putting the boundary condition at ease. So this will imply that sine of x can also be c, and this I can write as sine lx plus d and cos lx. And this is the solution for when x is between minus a and plus a. So we have solved the Schrödinger wave equation for three regions, region 1 and region 3 and region 2. Region 1 and 2 are the same, region 1 and 3 are the same, they are symmetric with each other, while region 2 is having different solution and potential is applied there as well. Now we are having the boundary condition, and the boundary conditions are that psi and d psi